Thanks, Richard. It's been a disappointing start for Everton, but they believe they've turned the corner. And against Bolton in midweek, Tim Howard kept his first clean sheet of the season. In front of him, an experienced and solid-looking back four, all the more surprising then that they've conceded 19 goals, the worst record in the division. Leon Osman came through a late fitness test to take his place in an unchanged Everton midfield. Whilst in attack, Tim Cahill returns in place of former Fulham striker Louis Sahar. He'll play just behind Yakubu, who scored a hat-trick in this fixture last season. Sahar, one of three strikers on the Everton subs bench, along with James Vaughan and Victor Anichebe.
Well, you talked about that back four, Alan, and I think that now that David Moyes might have settled in the quartet we see there. Played in the last two games, much better against United, only conceded the one, first clean sheet of the season. The following game, it suggests that back four have started to get it together. Ahead of that, the one little change, and it's a subtle one, but an important one, is Cahill in for Louis Saha. Saha would normally have played right up top alongside the Yak, but what you'll find with Tim Cahill, he'll wander about all over the place and he'll drift. He'll help the midfield when he has to, but when there's a ball in the penalty area, you can bet your life that Cahill will be very, very close to it.
Well, Roy Hodgson names the same Fulham team for the fourth game in a row. Mark Schwarzer in goal. A settled back four that's played together in virtually every match so far. More continuity in midfield, which includes former Liverpool player Danny Murphy and Simon Davis, one of two ex-Evertonians in the side. The other, of course, Andy Johnson, who'll play up front alongside Bobby Zamora. On the bench, Fulham include Clint Dempsey, who came on to score an equaliser in their last away game at Portsmouth.
Well, you talked about continuity, Alan, and 9 out of the 11 here have started every Premier League game this season, so that's brilliant to have. I just think this game's going to be won across that midfield area. We've got 8 midfield players, and Davis, Bullard, Murphy and Zoltán Gyökér are the 4 of Fulham's. I think whichever 4 dominate the ball and dominate the midfield area will then provide enough service for the front 2 players to win the game for them. So I think that is a big key area today.
Well, to Everton's embarrassment, they have the worst home record in all 4 divisions of English football. Played 5, won none, drawn 2, lost 3. A far cry from last season, when the only games they lost here at Goodison were against the top 4. Now, fortunately for David Moyes, their away form has been excellent, and their midweek victory at Bolton took Everton on to 12 points. If they beat Fulham today, they'll actually rise to 7th place, Andy, in the Premier League table. So perhaps their position is not as bad as it seems.
Well, only rise for a couple of hours at least, until the rest of the fixtures. I know, I don't know what to expect today. You've got the worst home record, you mentioned it, in the Premier League in Everton, and the worst away record in the Premier League in Fulham. So, what's going to happen? I don't know. It certainly won't be 0-0. That's how I've got a feeling about this game. I think it'll be open.
Fulham are only 3 points above the relegation places, by the way, but they have played a game less than all the other teams in the bottom half. They're 14th at kick-off, 11 points from 9 games, having beaten Wigan 2-0 on Wednesday.
Yeah, but do you know the game in hand is?
I think it's Manchester United, isn't
away.
It?
Away, yeah.
Yeah, tricky.
Yeah, exactly.
Everton's next fixture is away to West Ham, and when you look at their November commitments, Everton must fancy that they can rise up the table and stay in the right half. Handshakes, particularly from Danny Murphy, who knows so many of these Everton players from his days at Anfield. Quite a way back now, of course. He's become almost an adopted cockney. He's still very much a Liverpool red at heart. Crowded dressing room corridor here. Old-fashioned stadium, of course, and plans for Everton to move to a new ground have been put on ice for the foreseeable future.
A lot of smiles, a lot of banter in that tunnel. A lot of games you go to, people are really focused, and there's very little banter, but there's an awful lot there. We've got Schwarzer, obviously, talking to Cahill. Lots of players know each other from internationals.
Andy Johnson, AJ, as they all call him here. Very popular former Everton player. And the links continue in the dugouts as well, because David Moyes' first game as Everton manager was against Fulham, a 2-1 win here 6.5 years ago. What a mild afternoon in view of the weather that we had previously this week, as the famous Z Cars theme heralds the arrival of the teams, both of whom had gone 5 games without a win before this week. Everton's barren spell ended when their new star, Marouane Fellaini, scored a last-minute winner at Bolton. Fulham recording their first win in 6, thanks to 2 goals by Andy Johnson against Wigan. Now, Everton go in search of their first home win. Fulham, their first 3 points on the road. We're live at lunchtime here at Goodison as Everton take on Fulham. Well, here's one man Fulham didn't want to see today. Everton striker Yakubu has scored more goals against them than any other club in the Premier League, including a hat-trick in the space of less than half an hour in the corresponding game last season. Andy Johnson came off the Everton subs bench to replace Yakubu that day. Now he'll be trying to score against his old club, having finally opened his account for Fulham in their midweek victory over Wigan.
Leon
Roy Hodgson looks on. David Moyes focused.
And number 25, Marouane Fellaini.
Lee Mason, the referee. The teams separated by just 1 point and 2 places in the Premier League table. And if we have a winner here today, they'll move up to 7th place for a couple of hours at least. Fulham, by the way, have never won a league game at Goodison Park. And you have to go back almost 50 years to find the last time they avoided defeat here. The sun comes out to greet kick-off. Fulham in their usual white shirts and black shorts. Everton in royal blue. And the new multicoloured winter football in use for the first time this season.
What a beautiful sunny day.
Great. As will always happen. Konchesky looking for Zamora. It went over Yobo's head. Jagielka with the clearance. Andy Johnson, a very popular former player here. I'm sure he'll get a good greeting from the Everton fans who enjoyed his 100% contribution. He left here in August after 2 years as a Blue.
Yeah, they'll only enjoy it if Everton win, mind you.
True enough.
I mean, this is a game I think that takes a different shape on in the events of what's happened in the last week. A good point at Pompey and a home win for Fulham. A great point against Manchester United and an away win at Bolton. And I think both these teams now, 7 days later, are much more confident, feel much happier about coming out and playing and actually winning the game.
Here's Osman, who was a doubt for this game. He's had a recurring knee problem that might need an operation to sort out eventually. First free kick of the game for Everton.
Well, first opportunity for Everton, depending on what they want to do. Fellaini will definitely trot up in there. Lescott, Jagielka. Cahill, we know, is very good in the air. Ignore him at your peril.
And you can usually trust Arteta to get the delivery right. Fellaini spinning away, but Fulham defended it well. And as far as Neville, the Everton captain. Fellaini up well. Cahill had a sort of swipe at that, but miskicked.
Half a chance. Good play from Gary Neville. And thinking as the ball comes out to him, one touch and deliver. That's exactly what he does. This is not a great free kick from Arteta, but this is exactly what you expect. One touch to set it and drop it back in there again. A good little knockdown, and well, he gets something on that, Cahill. And it might just have been the perfect start.
Neville over Pienaar's head to Konchesky. Cahill there to win it back for Everton. Pienaar. Everton have won only 3 of their 10 league games, all away at West Bromwich Albion, Stoke and Bolton. They haven't won here since the final day of last season. Just 2 points at Goodison so far. Helmet, helmet, helmet. is at a loss to explain that form as well. Recently signed a new five-year extension to his contract, David Moyes. He's already Everton's longest-serving manager since the days of Harry Kattrick in the 1960s and early 70s. Pienaar. Neville. One back by Murphy. Zamora for Fulham. Murphy tried to curl one around the outside for Johnson.
Well, those are areas that Andy Johnson will happily explore down the channels.
Willard, Guerra, Konchesky. Well, trying to get away from Fellaini, who nudged him, but it's only a throw, and an Everton throw at that. Well, they're mystified. Fulham two places, but only a point behind Everton. Osman gives one for Yakubu to chase. Got a Fulham throw. Zamora's header on. Johnson beaten to it by Jagielka. Two Everton men went for the same ball then. They've got away with it though. Jagielka, very consistent figure. He's played every minute of every game this season. Yakubu up against Hughes. Here's Bullard. Sloppy layoff straight to Arteta. Now Lescott. Patient build-up from the home side. Joseph Yobo.
You know, if the ball goes forward, it has to be delivered into an area that they can deal with it. Those kind of balls, I think just Hughes and Hangeland will be very, very happy to see delivered towards the Yak. It's got to be delivered from the neck down, so to speak, so that they can get control of it.
And Zamora in the aerial battle with Yobo at the other end, although Yobo just stood off him. Almost as though he anticipated Zamora's misjudgment.
Yeah. A little bit of communication. Bobby Zamora might just have pulled that out there. Someone tells him to hold it.
Header on by Cahill. Away by Hughes to Bullard. Murphy took it in his stride. Zamora caught Bullard by surprise.
Pity that was a move that was going forward at a nice tempo, a nice pace. That little flick just put everyone on the back foot.
Good target man, he's only scored one goal so far. Only scored one for West Ham last season as well. Bullard. Now Yakubu for Everton. Murphy brushes him aside, no foul. Zamora. Johnson in space. This is the kind of position he loves to attack. Good defending by Yobo. Davis. Former Everton man looked for Zamora but dropped his cross short. Konchesky, Bullard. Easy for Osman.
The biggest threat so far. That little break from Fulham.
Well, as you anticipated, Andy, when they get the ball down and play, Fulham look aside.
Well, they've got four players in there that would rather be on the ball than off it. And to be fair, so have Everton. That's why you just don't know how this is going to unfold this game.
Hangeland. Zamora got a flick on, but no problem for Howard. Cahill using his aerial ability again. He put Hangeland off. Yakubu tries to get it back to him. Hangeland got the better this time. Zamora. Neville wins it back for Everton. Fellaini. Jagielka with time to make up his mind. Well, not the best ball. Hansel intercepts. Davis. Cahill. Arteta. did well to reach that. Bakubu and Cahill in the middle. And Pienaar failed to find Osman. Good pressure though this from Everton. Lescott. Now Neville. Pienaar goes wide. That's a good ball for Neville. Bakubu coming in.
Good take. Good take from Schwarzer, one-handed. It's always risky. Don't get the full hand on it, you can easily spill it. This is a good little build-up from Everton again. And again, a bit of quality from the wide areas from Phil Neville. I actually think both teams will quite enjoy this game. But I don't see too many people who are going to put tackles in, break the game up. I think when the teams get the ball down, they'll get time. If they're good enough to pop the ball about, manoeuvre it about the pitch.
Osman brings Everton on the attack again. Arteta just got a bit too much on his second touch there, allowing Pansel to make the tackle, the former West Ham fullback. There have been a lot of goals scored in Everton's Premier League fixtures so far this season. Not many in Fulham, so something's got to give one way or the other. Lescott, Yakubu, and he's won it back off Hughes. Pansel wasn't strong either in the challenge. Cahill, Pienaar and Yakubu ahead of him, Arteta down the left. Pienaar's header.
Well, when you're that far beyond the front post and the ball's as low as it is and there's not a great deal of pace in it, the header's a difficult one. You know, it's just digged in, he tries to put the power on it himself. Difficult, difficult chance. Certainly to score with a header. But they were a little sloppy there at the back for them.
Jagielka. Fellaini.
Just a little quiet here at Goodison, don't you think, at the moment? Moments as if the Goodison faithful are waiting for something to happen.
It's been a strange season so far for Evertonians. A lot of disappointment that they weren't more active in the transfer market in the summer. Then there was the doubts about David Moyes' future, doubts which have now been cleared up, of course. Doesn't help that the team across Stanley Park are top of the table at the moment.
No, it doesn't.
Jagielka up against Johnson. Pansel just helps it on. Fellaini, oop, bit strong that for Lescott. And Davis intercepts. And now it's broken to Johnson. Here's Jimmy Buller. Murphy. Pansel again. Good run here from Guerra. Did well. Davis. Johnson near post. Hill finds Yakubu. Oh, that's good control.
And a chance here to break. Phil Neville really has gone forward here.
Pienaar, the young South African, taking it on and finding Leon Osman. Just hesitated.
Yeah, just crowded out the edge of the box there.
Wasn't the best layup there from Zamora. Almost had his team in trouble. I guess Everton's poor start is more surprising because they finished fifth last season on 65 points. It's the most they've ever had in the Premier League. And of course, they also made the semi-finals of the Carling Cup, last 16 of the UEFA Cup.
I think the surprise has been, for me, certainly this season, has been how poor they've been at the back and how many goals they've conceded. What are they, 19 now? They're nearly at 20 goals conceded in 10 league games. It's, you know, that is an awful lot for a David Moyes team.
Quite a crowded out. Yes, again, last season, only the top four conceded fewer goals than Everton.
There you go. So that, I think that's something that they're trying to get back into the game. It's been tough to play against, tough to beat. As I said, the last two games, Man United here and Bolton away, only the one goal conceded. You know, and at times I think David Moyes' side might be evolving a little. You know, when you think last year, Carsley and Phil Neville probably at times played centre midfield more often than not, two holding, breaking up the play midfield players. I don't have too many like that at the moment when you look across the midfield.
Certainly a very attacking lineup that David Moyes has selected today. Fellaini, the man in the goals at the moment. With a hairstyle like that, he just needs a moustache and a shell suit. He could be one of Harry Enfield's scousers, couldn't he? Apparently he doesn't speak a word of the Queen's English, I'm told. Scousers will soon teach him.
I'm glad you said that.
Well, I haven't been born in the city, I think I can get away with it.
You can.
Lescott, and so goes in strongly, goal kick. Almost a year now since Roy Hodgson replaced Laurie Sanchez as manager of Fulham. Kept them up on the final day of the season, of course.
Well, if Everton weren't busy in the transfer market this summer, Roy was. I mean, it was almost a total clean out of staff. I think about 17 players went and 10, 12 came in. It was quite a clear out from the Fulham boss, stamping his own authority on it.
Hughes, very experienced Premier League player, picking out Davis. Bullard, tripped by Cahill. Tim Cahill just back from a three-match suspension. He was sent off here against Liverpool. Bit of space for Pienaar to get at Konchesky. Yakubu makes the run for him.
Unlucky. Able to drag that out the air, it may have been interesting.
Solid defending as ever by Yobo. Made his Everton debut against Fulham 6 years ago now in a 2-0 victory here. Fulham have an appalling record on this ground. Pansil. Here's Murphy. Hughes. Nothing much on, so he lifts it up for Zamora, holding off Yobo. Davis, now Guerra.
Oh, the final ball's a poor one. That was a decent ball for Hughes. That's the kind of ball I'm talking about. Everton have to deliver at times up to the yak. The ball into Zamora there was played where he could deal with it and where he could bring support players into play.
Quiet opening quarter of an hour.
Yeah, a little bit of sparring going on, isn't
there? Good header away by Hughes. Les got onto it. So was Murphy for Fulham, though. Now Bullard. Giving Konchesky a bit to do. Guerra. Fellaini. Neville finds Osman. On to Lescott. Not an easy one there for Arteta. Tetter again, little back heeler, straight to Pansil. Davis will break, he's got Zamora and Johnson ahead of him.
I actually think that Jagielka and Yobo are well equipped to deal with Zamora and Johnson. It's all about movement with those two. And I think Yobo and Jagielka are certainly equipped to deal with movement.
He's a giant hang-a-lang. Home fans felt the first challenge was a foul, the referee gave it for the second one.
But it's a better ball in, and Jack would appreciate that. You see, he can get his body between the defender and the ball, can actually make something happen. Well, it's right on his limit, I would guess, but I would think it's within his scope for Arteta to hit this. If he fancies it.
Scored a couple of goals this season, Mikel Arteta, one of them a penalty against Newcastle in the 2-2 draw here.
You see, because it's so straight, this is a difficult one to dink up. So he may just take this on, Mikel Arteta.
Oh, the deflection could have easily wrong-footed the goalkeeper. Good save by Schwarzer in the end.
No, it looks like he's just trying to save the corner. This is not his best struck free kick, Mikel Arteta. It's well wide and Schwarzer knows that, just trying to pad it out for a throw-in, but couldn't get enough on it.
That's Scott and Jovo both forward, so is Jagielka near post. He tried to get the flick on and it went clean through the crowd of players to get it. Bullock took that one well. Murphy. Jovo getting the better of Zamora at the moment, but here's Guerra for Fulham. Now Konchesky. Along the ground this time for Guerra. Good play by Osman. Everett's clearance charged down. Osman there again. He does a terrific job for Everton, Leon Osman. Dispossessed by the South African who finds Fellaini. Good vision from him to pick out Arteta. Lescott in support. In it goes for Yakubu. Easy for Schwarzer.
I think that Mark Schwarzer's name written all over it, that one.
Bullard. Good to see him back again. He's only missed one game this season, and that was when he was rested for a Carling Cup tie after all his injury problems. Peanut. Cahill. Final ball not coming off at the moment for either side. Bullard. That could be a great ball for Zamora, just a shade too much on it.
Well, they had to play it from it to get it through the gap because the gap wasn't big enough for a lazy pass. So he's got to smash that one through there. He was just looking for the feet of Zamora rather than in front of him.
Arteta. Clever, he's lost Pantsil. And finds Osman. Let's go forward. And Johnson leaves the break for Fulham.
No, that's poor. That really is poor from Bobby Zamora, that break there. Should have been keeping possession.
Did well to win it back, but Fellaini's a big lad. He won't be brushed aside easily. Murphy there to clean up for Fulham. Schwarzer's clearance finds Guerra. Poor touch, allowing Osman to intercept. Fellaini. And again, Pino.
Just mixed up. Yeah, wanted it down the line. Well, I talked about there not being, I didn't think a lot of players that broke the play up. What are we, a quarter of the game in? And look at that, only three free kicks in 22 minutes. Quite refreshing.
Here's Murphy. On to Jimmy Bullard. He's scored some spectacular goals down the years.
Well, it's worth a hit. I mean, neither goalkeeper's had much to do. Certainly just worked a yard or two for himself. Shot was there to take. It's just, I don't know about the game, it's comfortable, isn't it? You know, it's a word to use for both sides. I mean, the way side here, Fulham will be fairly happy at the pace of the game's at and the tempo it's at, getting enough of the ball. You know, Everton obviously with a home record, they're a tad nervy, you guess. I just think that they've got to just up it a little bit, Everton.
Yeah, neither side's really shown their hand yet.
Yeah, just Everton doing everything a little quicker all over the pitch. Just work Fulham a little quicker and a little more often.
Yobo in towards Yakubu. Fellaini just ahead of him. It's reached Yakubu. Strong there, Yakubu, really strong. First time Fulham have looked a little ragged at the back. Neville, good ball. Arteta, oh well played, unlucky. Bullard saw what he was doing. Still got it, Arteta. Now Fellaini, Pansel is lying injured, the Fulham defender in the box. Osman. And Fulham aren't happy that Everton didn't knock the ball out of play initially.
No, I mean, we know what we're trying to do in this league, and that is let the referee decide whether treatment is needed and play should come to a halt. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. You see Pansel come in here, he gets smashed by Hangeland, and that's where he stays down, and he'll be okay, I would imagine, John Pansel. He'll have felt that from his centre-back.
6 foot five of Scandinavian muscle and bone, hammers into you like that, he's bound to be feeling the effects. Well, he sees the funny side. I'm not sure the manager or Pansel do.
He'll be fairly pleased. Roy Hodgson, I can only think of Pienaar's header, which wasn't really a chance. It was the only little scare they've had 25 minutes into this game.
Cardiff against Wolves is our championship offering. Big game that at Ninian Park tonight. Yep. 5:15, Sky Sports 1 and High Definition.
Dave Jones might like to win that,
yeah.
More than one or two reasons.
Well, Pansel limping off, inspecting the damage inflicted by his own teammate.
They've just switched the last 5-10 minutes or so. They've switched Arteta and Pienaar, David Moyes. They do have the ability to do that. They're comfortable either side, those two players.
Lescott. Yakubu flicks on to Cahill. Hughes with him. Pansel back on the field for Fulham. And closing down Pienaar here. It's a good ball over Osman. Oh, just escaped his control. Guerra. Bullard.
Pity. Good spot from Pienaar. He was in a lovely position, Leon Osman.
Murphy helps it on to Davis. Zamora has drifted wide. Danny Murphy. Pansel. Back again to Davis. Well, he certainly reads the game well, doesn't he? He's in the right place every time. But here's Zamora. And now Johnson. Bullard shot.
That was more difficult. Ball coming back to him quite firmly from Andy Johnson. Must have taken it very quickly. Never really got control of it. You know, but with the record Fulham have got away from home, you would have to think that the point to start with would not be a bad point for them to finish with. So definitely, the onus very much on Everton to push forward and ask the questions and take the game to them. And certainly in the opening 27 minutes, not enough attempts from Everton on goal.
Might be one coming now though. Yakubu. Arteta. Fellaini. Oh, against the post. Yakubu couldn't snatch the rebound.
Well, this is brilliant defending by Aaron Hughes at the end of this. Because Yakubu scores if he doesn't do a good defending job here. You think the chance is gone here, then they kind of waste it. But watch this from Fellaini. Just works a little half a yard. He thinks he scored, but Aaron Hughes' interception there as the Yak was pulling the trigger from the rebound was first class. I think Pansel's struggling.
Yeah, he knocked the ball out of play deliberately there to either get treatment or enable the substitution to be made.
Well, I'll have a look at the end of this again. And just watch Aaron Hughes here. He's on the edge of the box here with Yakubu. And if he had just switched off, then Yakubu's tapping it in. But he gets back in with Yakubu and manages to get a block on the rebound. Top defending.
Hansel off the field again for Fulham. Down to 10 for the moment. They have got Fredrik Skur, the Swedish international, who can go in at right back. He's among their substitutes. Seem ready to send Pansel back out there, and the referees waved him off.
As I say, it was an impact injury, and if it was run about the hip bone or somewhere like that, it might just be getting a bit stiff and painful. See if he can run it off.
Pina, what a good ball that was for Leska.
Oof. Well, just for the last 5 minutes, Everton have just turned the tempo up a little bit. And I think that corresponds with the best spell they've had.
Hughes twice to the rescue. That second time he had a little bit of luck on his side. That clearance could have ended up anywhere. Jelka again goes near post. Les got up well. It's been punched out to Osman. Blocked by Zamora for another Everton corner. Kubu and Pansel having a bit of fun there on the near post. Wasted corner, they've got another chance though.
Yeah, what is that about Fulham? Jimmy Boulard the other week, messing about with one of the players in the wall. Pansel doing it at the near post with the Yak. Yak doesn't look too pleased about it.
In the end, Lescott's header sails wide.
That's a decent ball in. It's only a decent area, maybe Fellaini. Well, you see, he doesn't speak English very well, so there's no point in him giving a shout to Lescott to leave that for him.
Half an hour gone at Goodison. Still goalless in a game that usually does produce goals. Arteta. Kubu looked as though he could have been fouled by Handeland. The referee lets play go on, but Pienaar has lost possession. And Chesky also now to Pienaar. Back to Arteta.
Wrong choice. Wrong choice. Handeland had read the pass long before he played it.
Neville. Oh, a lovely flick from Arteta to Pienaar. Good skill. Neville. Good move this by Everton. Just too much, was it? Yeah.
Yeah, but this is all better. The last 7 or 8 minutes of this match, you can just tell Everton have raised the tempo of the game a little bit.
And the crowd respond accordingly. Everton have won all 7 home games against Fulham in the Premier League. 3-0 last season, they lost 1-0 at Craven Cottage. Bullard. Here's Davis. Bullard's early cross, Zamora, good goalkeeping, he's come to Johnson. Just couldn't get it out of his feet, Zamora.
What
Everton
a chance.
Survived.
What a chance. What a ball in from Jimmy Bullard. That's the best cross in the match by a distance. He fizzes it in, Zamora gets across the front. Oh, I think he should score there. It's across the front of Yobo. Goes and heads that. Really means to head it, and I think he probably scores. Does it sit for Johnson? Eventually scramble it away. But what a ball it was from Jimmy Bullard.
Pienaar. Lescott. Got to go back to Jagielka. And that's sloppy play by him. Yeovil there to his rescue, though. Davis, Bullard. Produced that great cross moments earlier. And there's another one for Zamora. Too close to Howard, though.
No. Good starting position. Tim Howard could read that.
Well, Bullard has suddenly started to look very effective going out to the right. Osman. Well played. Neville. Now for Jagielka. Lescott closed down immediately by Davis. Fellaini. Pinar survived the challenge. The referee would have given the free kick. Not sure whether he did. He has in the end. And yeah, he tried to play advantage, didn't he?
Well, Fellaini tried to take a quick one, but Pinar didn't get up.
Slight build, Pinar. Very talented footballer, though. Here's Cahill. Ansel wins it back. Bullard. Zamora.
And it was a little unlucky. He thought that Andy Jones had turned the other way. Just tried to drop the ball back into his path.
Arteta to Pinar. Quicker passing move this by Everton. Lescott. Pinar. In towards Fellaini again. Whoops.
Flag went up, offside. Cahill's not. Fellaini's the one who's just drifted a little early. Does like to get forward, doesn't quite get back onside.
Here's Guerra now with a bit of space for Fulham. Zamora, Johnson, Yeovil got there first. Bullard seems to be popping up all over the place at the moment. Jimmy Bullard, that's a great ball in as well for Zamora. He claims he was fouled. Murphy with the shot, deflected.
A great block by Jagielka there. He really did get himself in front of that shot from Danny Murphy. It was struck really well.
Game's livening up now. Bullard for Fulham. More and more influential he's becoming. Pantsuk. That came off Jagielka for a corner.
Well, slow to get up, and I think that's a result of the block that came from this. Danny Murphy really does get hold of this. Really good block there. And at the other end, I'm not so sure why Zamora's not going and heading that. I don't know who he's trying to chest that down to. Another great ball in from Bullard to him. And that's another chance wasted.
Fulham's first corner, 10 minutes before half-time. Not a very good one.
Well, he was looking for a quick break, but there was nothing on.
Yeovil with the long ball for Arteta. Konchesky wins the header. Fellaini. Back to Neville. Now Osman. Julian Lescott. Here's Jagielka for Everton. Cleared by Hughes. Johnson quick to see possibilities. But the referee gives Everton the free kick here.
The referee's probably bored. He's not been asked to make any decision whatsoever in this game, Lee Mason. Such an easy game to referee. I can't believe it.
Great little header there. Cahill to Pinar. Yakubu went for it. Fellaini also miscontrolled it as Konchesky clears.
Well, there's been two or three really good chances, I feel, from crosses. Neither team has made the best of. Won't get that. Well, he does like to get forward, doesn't he, Fellaini? Time and time again. He drifts into that top area of the pitch. He does it again there behind Konchesky, who doesn't see him. And if he just controls this better, well, he's got himself a chance.
Well, the Everton fans have certainly taken to him. The club is a record buy. A reported £15 million from the Belgian club Standard Liège. Pina. Leskop plays one over the top for Yakubu. Guerra. That's disappointing from a talented footballer. Neville. Arteta. Just showed it to Murphy. Leskop. Pencil under pressure from Yakubu. Foul there by Zamora.
Well, he's arguing he just stood his ground. It's a little nudge, but he does go down very easily, Phil Jagielka.
Now Phil Neville. Arteta.
Nothing.
Ends up back where he started, Phil Neville. Longer this time. Oh, that was Hangaran climbing all over Fellaini.
Well, I'm going to tell you something. It might be soft, but if that's not a free kick, then I don't know what is.
Well, he had his hands on his shoulders, didn't he?
It's a free kick, and if it's in the area, it makes that penalty.
Arteta. Hangaran wins it back fairly this time. Konchesky. Get out. Fouled by Pina.
Well, you make your own mind up. Does he jump up? Does he get allow Fellaini to get a chance at this? That, I guarantee you, 99 times out of 100, if it's not in the penalty area, it's a foul. The referee's got no excuse. He's looking right at it. That's a really, really poor decision. It might be soft, as far as Fulham are concerned, but you can't do that.
Well, he definitely stopped Fellaini jumping for the ball, didn't he? Here he is again, Arteta. Neville. Jagielka down the centre, and Cahill claimed that Hangaran touched that with his hand.
I think it was actually Cahill's arm that the ball brushed against.
Neville wins it back. Osman. Here's Arteta. Neville.
Well tracked by Zoltan Guerra. Part of the job. The fullback goes forward, but you're playing against to track him back.
Now Fulham got the throw. Everton getting the upper hand here as the half draws to a close.
I think Everton have been the better side. They've had the chances. Should have had a penalty, in my opinion. Not even a question about it.
I think you said it many times before. If it happened anywhere else on the field, free kick, definitely.
I mean, why should that make a difference, eh?
Shouldn't. Yobo. Now Yakubu's found a bit of room between the centre-backs. Hughes to the rescue again for Fulham.
Yeah, he dealt well with that. He made the decision, even if Schwarzer was coming and calling. Aaron Hughes thought, no, I'm just going to get this out the danger area.
Johnson. Uses his pace to get round Jagielka, but he's overrun it.
I mean, have a look at this and make your own minds up. But anywhere else on the pitch, would that be a free kick? The answer is 100% yes. You just cannot do that. And you certainly can't do it in the penalty area. Somehow, Lee Mason thinks it isn't a penalty, which is extraordinary.
Cahill. Mullaney. Onto Pina. And Schwartz has come and taken everything. Really settled in well at Fulham, hasn't he, after his long spell at Middlesbrough. Over 400 games for them. Konchesky. Yobo getting the better of Zamora consistently. Willard. Angolan back to Bullard. Trading half for David Moyes. Everton have most certainly had the better of it without really testing Schwarzer as yet.
No, strike off the post. Biggest threat. There's no doubt when he sees that challenge of Angolan's, he'll wonder why on earth his team didn't get an opportunity to open scoring from a penalty spot.
Murphy, Davis. There's Bullard. Into Johnson, Jagielka. Shirt tight to him, he finds Davis though. Now Murphy. Osman intercepts. Neville for Everton. Yakubu. I don't think there's going to be much stoppage time as it goes long to Arteta, who's got Cahill up with him in the box. Zamora. One back by Yobo, who's had a really good half. Osman. In behind Lescott. Fellaini. Pina. Fulham keeping a disciplined shape, making it difficult for Everton to find gaps. Jagielka does though with a splendid ball to Lescott.
Just the 1 minute. The official has indicated there will be a minimum of 1 minute of added time. 1 minute.
Fellaini. He's laid it off straight to Davis. Pina. Lescott still forward from the earlier attack and finds Arteta.
Well, a little surprise at Mikel Arteta, but he didn't get hold of that. He's got fantastic skills. It was an awkward attempt at a shot.
That is still waiting to spark into life, in all honesty. Everton have certainly had the better of this first 45 minutes. Might have had a penalty when Hanglang had his hands on the shoulders of Fellaini, who also hit the post earlier in the half. It's Everton 0, Fulham 0. Sun shining for the start of the second half as well. Everton will get us underway.
Yeah, right, no changes by right into Tim Howard's eyes, that sunshine as well. Interesting, a lot of goalkeepers don't wear caps. Tim Howard, one of those again, not interested in it, just putting his hand up at the moment to shield his eyes from the sun. See if that plays a part at any time, should it stay out.
Let's go forward, away by Hughes. He made a couple of excellent interceptions to keep the score sheet blank in the first half. Neville. Fellaini. Lescott, Arteta back on the left again, and nudged over by Pansil.
Well, there you see, not got the cap, but just using the hand to shield it. Oh, he's got a cap now, I've just noticed there, just called for one. One round, there you go, not taking any chances.
At the other end, Arteta plays it forward for Lescott. Pienaar missed his kick. Yobo And now Neville, plenty in the box here. Hughes knocks it out only as far as Arteta. Here's Lescott. The Spaniard takes over. And the header by Cahill.
Well, they can't head the ball, and you wouldn't have been surprised if Tim Cahill had found the target here. 10 yards out, it's within his compass, just gets a little ahead of it. Yeah, a little ahead of it.
Fulham are the only Premier League team that Tim Cahill has never scored against, by the way.
Bad record.
Osman, charged down by Bullard. Konchesky now. One for Zamora to chase. Johnson in behind him. Guerra. Bullard. Crowded out by Cahill. Pienaar takes it on for Everton. Early for Yakubu. Hangeland with an excellent piece of defending. Murphy. Guerra. Hangeland finds Johnson. Well, Johnson thought he was going to get the free kick for Yobo's challenge. He's wrong.
No, he thinks that the first one here is a free kick. It wasn't. But why a free kick's given against him? I'm not sure myself.
Guerra. Neville wins it back for Everton. Here's Yobo. Cooper had come forward, anticipating an offside flag. Spotted the foul there by Fellaini on Konchesky.
Interesting to hear what he said to his players at half-time. Got plenty of options, certainly at the top end of the pitch, to use in the second half, David Moyes, should he need to. Tim Howard can't make his mind up, cap or no cap, it's off again.
England diving in there, and the referee belatedly awards Everton the free kick. I think uncompromising is the word you might use about Hangeland. Fellaini trying to get away from Pansel. Oh, he hit the defender on the back, he knew nothing about that. Arteta. Pulls it up to the back post. Well, it was a trademark situation for Cahill, but this time, not accurate enough.
Well, he'll think he should score, and so do I, because he's that good in the air. Beautiful piece of play for Arteta, just checks, and then gets his half yard there. And that's a wonderful dinked ball up. He's got the running Konchesky. Cahill, he knows he's going to out-jump him because of that. He doesn't get the ball down. Good leap. Got a bad header. And he knows he should have hit the target.
He did score in the first two league games of the season, none since, although he has been out for three matches through suspension. Yakubu bursts into life and forces the error from Pansel. Everton corner.
Well, this has been a really good start for Everton second half. Over the 5 minutes, have been right on the front foot. Cahill's had two headed opportunities, one of which he might have done better with.
Fellaini being watched closely by Hangeland, and Schwarzer with a spectacular punch clear.
I'm sorry, but...
Should have caught it, you could
well,
say.
I was, but no, I'm not a goalkeeper.
It's gone out, surely.
That's what I mean there, Phil Neville, getting the ball, running and taking it, doing everything a little quicker. Just feel Everton need to do that this second half.
Jagielka. Hangeland wins the header with ease. Pienaar. Now Mikel Arteta for Everton.
Dan Murphy did well to get across here. Arteta's always looking to get this back on his right foot when he gets it there. And as he turns inside, along comes Murphy just to get in his face.
Yilwell's clearance, and Hengan, a solid wall again at the back for Fulham. Roy Hodgson's first signing. He played for him in Norway as well. Signed from the Danish league last season. Jagielka for Everton. Might test him again here. Cahill spins off his marker. Looks more promising this for Everton. Pina. Arteta. Fellaini's offside.
There he is. Well, he gets in there, but he just drifts in a little early at times. Makes the run and, well, he's a good yard offside.
And slow to react at the back for once, but Jagielka rushes Johnson aside. Here's Neville. Fellaini. He's now taken down by Konchesky.
Fucking ball, boys, get on the
field. Hasn't been a hint of a bad tackle yet in this game. But we want to have a word with Konchesky nonetheless. Cahill, good control on the chest. Pienaar, Okulu using his strength as well, cleared by Davis.
Well, at the moment Fulham just can't get the ball, can't get out their own half.
Fulham share with Stoke the dubious distinction of the worst away record in the Premier League, 1 point from four games. That was in their last match on the road at Pompey. They lost the other three. Hugely experienced, of course, Roy Hodgson. Maybe not to the younger viewers in our country, but he's been in eight different countries in his managerial career, 12 different clubs.
Oh, he's a good lad, know Roy very well. A lot of time for him.
And he did very well in his only previous spell in the English Premier League, didn't he, with Blackburn? Mm-hmm. Jagielka.
A little loose with that one, but they are trying to get the ball forward a little quicker if they have to, Everton. There's no doubt about that.
Davis wins it back, Murphy. Johnson persistent against Lescott, and he's earned his team a throw. Lescott's hurt his foot as well.
This might have kicked Andy Johnson there as he was trying to clear it.
Smattering of Fulham fans who've made the journey north, making themselves heard. Pansil, Bullard. Oops. Fellaini heads it on, and Cahill couldn't find Yakubu. Here's Neville.
Split his two teammates there.
It's been that kind of day so far.
I think both teams, you know, arrived here today knowing just how important 3 points is going to be in this fixture. You just have to look at the table, see how congested it is at that bottom end. And 3 points does make a massive difference to the caps back on again. Tim Howard. And this is the first time I can remember looking to my right and actually watching a Fulham attack this second half.
I think it's only their second corner of the game as well. Pangolan venturing forward. Oh, and he got something on that as well. Here's Zamora. Oh, it's against the bar by Guerra.
Oh, he's got to score. I am sorry, but he has got to score for Fulham. What a beautiful ball dinked back in from Bobby Zamora.
Panso. Well, they've broken out of defence and come closer to scoring than Everton have in this half. Johnson shot.
Well, Zoltan Gear is pretty good in the air, and he should score from this. When he goes in there first and then he takes another position, and then he comes off the penalty spot and he walks into a ball where he isn't challenged, which is just floating towards him, and there he meets it and he should score. Fulham, I don't think, will get a better chance than that this game.
Arteta. The Kugel offside.
Well, Arteta and Yak have a difference of opinion here. I think Yakuba must have known he was in an offside position.
Well, Louis Sahar was in the starting lineup for the midweek game against Bolton, left out today to accommodate the return of Tim Cahill. Will he see action soon? Former Fulham player, of course. No team has scored fewer goals in the Premier League than Fulham, just 8 in their 9 games before today. Not many chances come along. Will they regret that miss by Zoltán Gera?
That's a big chance, I mean that.
Robo skies his clearance and reaches his own ball. Here's Davis. Johnson flicks it on. Danger here, Bullard. Oh, not quite sure what he was intending to do then.
Yeah, a lot of frustration now from the Everton fans for 11, 12 minutes of this second half. It was just all Everton. Suddenly a little breakaway. They get the corner, Fulham, and then that strike off the bar. Everyone's got twitchy again.
Angelang's header drops between the two defenders. Pansel's mistake. Well played, Schwarzer. He's done everything that's been required of him so far, the big Aussie.
Which hasn't been a lot.
No. Put on. Davis robbed by Arteta.
Well, an interesting substitution. Who comes off? How adventurous is David Moyes going to be with Saha?
He has been playing alongside Yakubu.
Well, he's going to play up front, but it's just a matter of who comes off to accommodate that. All sorts of things he can do, David Moyes.
Meanwhile, it's Fulham continuing to frustrate the home fans here as Johnson bursts forward. Ooh, that was a no-holds-barred tackle with Osman and Johnson.
I'm not so sure they've got that right either. Osman saying he hit the ball against Johnson. Looking to get there, and then along comes Osman. That's exactly what he does.
Pencil's header miles wide.
You know, he could take off a midfield player here and put Cahill back into midfield and still have the two up front. That's what I mean about the options that he has. Or he could take Cahill and Yak off, keep it the same. So I'll be interested to see who is coming off.
Delaney, there you go. Appreciation for number 25,
well, the home fans, or some of them anyway, have rooted that decision. They're applauding, but there was also a loud boo.
Well, I mean, he obviously wants to keep Cahill on the pitch. Don't think there's anything wrong with that. And maybe he feels that if it was Cahill and Fellaini in that central area that they might get exposed. Osman has been a little more disciplined. I mean, he loves to get forward, Leon Osman, but he's been more disciplined in this game. I guess because Fellaini's is beside him. And I guess that maybe the communication and telling Fellaini, you have to sit a little bit. They might not be able to get that through to him.
Might also be worth pointing out that he can't play in the next game because he's racked up five yellow cards, so he's suspended for the match at West Ham as Yakubu and Pencil enjoy another little argument. Cut it out, says Mr. Mason. Free kick by Hughes. Zamora climbs. Away by Osman. And the first thing Sahara's done is earn a free kick. Crude challenge by Hangalan. Arteta. Osman. Good ball for Lesko. But he's offside.
That's a pity. I think we'd like to see a bit more of Julian Lescott that high up the pitch, second half, Everton. Just turns it around the corner, it's a lovely little ball that. Just a yard offside. But this is a chance of match. Now look at Guerra, what I'm saying is, no challenge. Nobody bumps him, nobody knocks him off his stride. He meets the ball beautifully, it's not flying at him at a great pace, it was just sat up beautifully by Zamora. Guerra's got to score.
Lovely ball, Arteta. Neville. Pienaar's been a little quiet in this half, and Konchesky easily wins that battle.
See, I thought he might have done that to David Moyes and said Pienaar off, keep Fellaini in the side and play Cahill from the right side. Could easily have done that, or kept Osman in the side. That was another option. But he obviously wants to keep the shape better.
Hangland a little push again there. He's got to be careful the way he uses his arms, and the goalkeeper had to be careful against Yakubu.
I just wonder if Konchesky's saying to Hangman, just be careful. I mean, that's not so much, that's just sort of keep his position and what have you. But then from this, goalkeeper comes, you think, take that, it's easy. Floating out, goes up and he's... just goes over Pancel, and as he lands, out it comes, spills it. Manages to scoop it back in.
Good kick from Schwarzer as well, almost too good. Goulard. Fulham may be starting to believe that they can win this game. Zamora. Foul by him.
That's a foul, and yet Hangalan all over the top of Fellaini first half, isn't it? Well, I think when Lee Mason sees that again, I'm sure he'll feel that he made a big mistake there. I don't think he could argue that. I'd be amazed if there's an argument from him, other than I'm sorry, yeah, I got it wrong.
So Hall's flick on, finds Yakubu. The tackle.
A little two-footed. That was a little two-footed from Guerra. That's what I would say.
That's a hard again. Oh, what a good ball. Arteta. Lescott screaming for the ball, edge of the box. He's gone forward instead. Murphy. A bit more pace to the game now. Bullard's layoff. Guerra. Whoops. Bullard miscontrols it. Pienaar in quickly.
Oh, shouldn't have played that. Carry it a little. Stephen Pienaar, just a little excited, trying to play it too quickly.
Willard, brought down by Neville. Guerra. Zamora wants it played into space, but Jagielka cut down that space brilliantly. Superb defending by Jagielka. Now it's livened up at long last. Murphy. Two tackles going in now.
Well, Cahill just... well, he rather swung at the ball that wasn't there, and I think he's made contact with Jimmy Bullard. When the ball kind of comes in between them here, and then it comes across, and just... almost hip throws Jimmy Boulard. The knee just went a little bit. He's shaking him up a little.
Referee was in the perfect place to see it again. His career was almost ended by serious injury, of course. Out something like 18 months, wasn't he? Arteta to Osman. Johnson, round the corner for Zamora. And Yagoka so quick to spot danger, his positioning perfect.
I just think that Bobby Zamora had reacted to the ball up to Johnson, almost knowing it was going round the corner. He was just a little late in reacting to the ball.
If he runs out of space, Cahill, Sahar, and Lance. It long and Zamora is caught offside.
No, just a quarter of this game left to decide. Well, that poor home record of Everton's continues.
Who will gamble? Who will go for broke here? Cahill for Everton. Neville. Pienaar up against Konchesky. Neville's cross. Now Arteta. Straight back in. Hughes heads it away. Osman onto the loose ball. Cahill could get nothing on the header.
No, he's never going to score. I think he's just trying to knock it down. Well, Leon Osman's down.
A lot of space here for Bullard. A lot of space. Wasted it. Well, he's a tough little character, Leon Osman. I think he had a couple of major operations before he was even 18. After joining Everton, he's had a knee problem that just won't go away. But every time you think he might drop out of the side through injury, he's there still. Issahar, Pienaar. And again, Osman. Neville. Scraps to try and win it back, but Pienaar was strong then. Good skill as well. Leon Osman. Neville's cross hits Gerda for a corner.
Jimmy Boulard just having the one bit referee there. I think he was knocked down just in that edge of the area skirmish.
Go beaten to the header by Zamora, Pienaar, Neville. Osman, first to react, but he's got too much on that. Well, 20 minutes for someone to try and win this.
You know, when you think 10, was it 10 points away from here? Only two here.
Here's Johnson. Foul by Jovo. Interesting position for this free kick for Fulham.
There you go. That's a definite free kick. They haven't done enough of that, Fulham. Zamora hasn't won enough of kind of ball at half. But now there's a conference going on. I mean, you take your pick, Boulard, Murphy, Guerra, Zamora, they all fancy it, they all want a word.
Well, Boulard scored two cracking free kicks last season in the Premier League.
Well, you could bet Danny Murphy, whose Liverpool connection, wouldn't mind sticking this one in at Gladys Street either.
He never lost against Everton in a Merseyside derby either. So maybe he's the good luck charm, let's see. Don't forget Konchesky's left foot either.
It's a good distance as well, Alan, to get it up and down. Far enough out that you've got some space to get it up and down, and also you can put some pace on it from there. And it looks like Bullard might just have made his mind up, he's the man.
It is Bullard, and it was brilliant, and Zamora turns it against the post.
Didn't quite hit it, and it almost paid off for him. Bobby Zamora scuffed it across goal, and it almost bobbled into the far corner.
Johnson, twice now in the second half, Fulham have hit the woodwork.
Well, Bullard does what he should do, and that's work the goalkeeper. It's not right in the corner, but he gets it up and over the wall, and it troubles him enough, Tim Howard. But then from there, this is a scuff shot. What do you see? Into the ground. Scuffs it across goal. Well, and luck is Everton's way. Very much so.
Another Fulham free kick. We'll have to take it again. Anglan, a possible target here, making a run from the left edge of the area. It's along the ground, and it's Guerra who slices it wide.
It's a decent free kick. He gets it up and over the wall. As I say, it's not right in the top corner, but it gave Tim Howard the problem. And Everton, well, they get fortunate. And Fulham, very, very close again.
Sahara's play continues with Bullard's challenge. Konchesky did well to find Guerra, who's gifted it back to Pino. Bad mistake by Guerra.
And that's even worse for Pino. Let's just give it away time here, isn't it? We'll get it back off you and we'll give you it straight back. There we go, another one.
Bizarre little period of play. Free kick, Callum Johnson. Well, I haven't been too many nil-nils in this fixture over the years. This shouldn't be nil-nil either. When you think of Guerra's missed chance, the scuff shot moments earlier by Zamora.
Yeah, Cahill's header for Laney hitting the post first half. There have been a host of chances, but there have been three or four very good ones.
The Kuvu takes a quick throw, intelligent play by him. Hughes just muscled out Lescott.
He's defended well, Alan Hughes. That was a decent game for his side.
Time for another change. Looks like Victor Anichibi, who normally stirs things up. Big, strong, physical young lad.
Well, you'd think he'd probably get him on. Maybe take Stephen Pienaar off. Take the three up top. Narrow it a little bit in midfield. Take a little chance to win the game. I know it's difficult because you don't want to lose the point that you have by taking a chance, but Everton have to start winning at home. And I think David Moyes knows that sooner rather than later.
Well, he should be scored as a substitute when Everton beat Fulham 4-1 here a couple of seasons ago. He's not been on the first team scene long. Prescott's awkward header. Cleared by Yobo. Final quarter of an hour being played at Goodison. Everton ready to make their change now. The last substitution was booed by a large section of the fans.
Stephen Pienaar, I'm not surprised. But he may have made this change first time around. He played Cahill from slightly right. The first change hasn't had the desired effect, so maybe this one will. Interesting to see if he plays him from the right or asks him to fill in there. Looks like it. his orders for me would be get yourself in the box as often as possible as well, young man, and make that physical presence tell.
Well, it normally doesn't take him long to start bouncing off a few people. Here's Johnson, Bullard. Back again to Bullard. To Mora in the centre, Guerra behind him, and it's broken to Danny Murphy.
Yeah, might have been better taking that with his left. He didn't want to, Danny. It's not his strongest side. And you watch at the end how awkward he is because he has to take it with his right. Look, he has to almost try and run round the ball to cut across it.
Davis onside here, Bobby Zamora, and Johnson up with him. Jagielka first to react again, but it's a corner.
Fulham are, you know, believing that they can play on Everton's nerves here, because Everton will be the twitchy ones. Home side still looking for that first home league win of the season. Fulham nothing to lose here.
Zamora's effort always off target. Championship action for you tomorrow on Sky Sports 1 and High Definition. Derby against Nottingham Forest. Great sounding fixture there. Here's Arteta. Got round Pansel cleverly, came off him, but deflected back off Arteta for a goal kick. Of course, we've got more Premier League action for you on Sky Sports tomorrow from the Reebok Stadium. Bolton against Manchester City. Our show starts at 3:30.
Yeah, if Roy Hodgson's side can keep hold of this point, we'd look back on the last week, two away games in this league and one at home and 5 points and unbeaten. You'd think that that's promising, something to build on.
And their next two games are both at Craven Cottage against clubs currently in the bottom four as well, Newcastle and Tottenham. Here's Yakubu battling away with Hangeland, and now with Konchesky, who wins it.
But this is a notorious league for late goals, between 80 and 90 minutes. An awful lot of goals scored in that period of the game.
Gives it away, Osman. Neville.
And it just shows you Roy Hodgson. I mean, he plays the same team, tries to select it time and time again. Talked about 9 of this 11 out there have started every Premier League game, and still no sign of a change either from Roy. Happy with the 11 he started with.
Escott's cross in behind Osman. Chance for Fulham to break. 4 against 4 at the moment. Bullard takes a tumble, and the referee just gives the throw. Bullard. Murphy. Konchesky hasn't ventured forward much in this second half. Guerra. Now Davis, former Everton player, finds Bullard. Thought about hitting that, and did eventually.
Well, that's a good way out. And just as I say, Roy Hodgson, there's weights and weights. I see there's some activity on the Fulham bench.
Only 10 minutes remain. Louis Sahar with wonderful control. Neville. Cahill. Here's Yobo. Fulham have backed away into their own half again. Jagielka.
James Wong ready to come on for Everton as well, so he's getting as many front players on the pitch, David Moyes, as he can for this last 10 minutes.
And each of you pulls one back just behind Louis Sahar. Davis. Decided to try and take on Lescott for pace, fails. Arteta. Into space for Yakubu, but Hughes has not missed a trick today. Davis by Cahill. stolen a few yards with that, or tried to anyway. Angelan. Here's Konchesky. Ooh, Lescott. Expected too much of Howard with the back pass.
You know, how many times have we seen goals conceded with sloppy defending like that? It's an easy header for Julian Lescott. Just makes a mess of it. Now he'll be doubly determined to win this header.
Well, he gets up well again.
Now, Andy Johnson's in that position in front of Howard, there should be. Takes that position, but he never really got himself across near the flight of the ball.
Huge kick by Howard, look at that. Two bounces, straight to the other goalkeeper who was fouled, will not count as a goal.
Well, the best one in the world. The keeper's never going to get that as a goal, is he? Keeper, eyes on the ball, yeah, just tips him up. I'm saying Andy Johnson there in front of the goalkeeper, but then when the corner came over, he never really got himself across the flight of the ball again. Might have just had a little tap in. He's just saying 10 minutes, think about it, team. I know that this is a good point, any point in this league when you're in the bottom half of that away from home is a very good point.
And made a change, Fulham making one too, Chris Baird coming on. He's also a late substitute against Wigan on Wednesday, that was his first appearance of the season in fact. He's replacing Jimmy Bullard.
Jimmy in no hurry to get off, take his time.
Everton substitution coming off number 22, show your appreciation for Yakubu. And Yakubu's replacement is number 14, James Vaughan.
James Vaughan, 20-year-old striker. Well, they've certainly got plenty of potential goal scorers out there at the moment, Everton. The order from the referee to Schwarzer, and he obliges, not terribly well actually with the kick, it's gone straight to Anichibi. Neville, long for Sahar, and Chesky fails to keep it in play. Sahar, Bourne is in the centre. Oh, that was an important header by Pansy. Arteta is right behind him. Lescott. Osman. That's got to do well. That wasn't an easy ball to control. Arteta. Dangerous one in. And Vaughan will have a headache. So too will Hughes. Zamora gives it away. So too did Cahill. And we're going through one of those spells again. 5 minutes to go at Goodison, where Everton have yet to win a game this season. The worst record in all four divisions of English football. Neville. Back to Yobo. On to Leon Osman. Well, Hendon, in his own no-nonsense way, has had a solid game. Might have conceded a penalty in the first half, but the referee didn't see it that way.
Well, with this home record, I'm just wondering if David Moyes would be happy to see four of the next six fixtures away from here.
Yes, it's strange how that turns around sometimes for teams. Angelan knocks it clear again, only as far as Osman. Here's Neville. Produce a late flurry of activity here. Osman.
Plenty in there, plenty up there.
Running with Sahar and Bourne. Sahar! Louis Sahar has surely finally brought Everton's Goodison nightmare to a close.
Well, that's another brilliant cross. And it's amazing how if you put a decent cross in there and you get enough players in there, you've got a chance. Well, Leon Osman, they don't get to him quick enough. They allow him to cross the ball and he drops it in a brilliant area. Not so sure about Hangerland's position. Not really marking anybody front post. He took an area rather than a man. And when this drops on Saha, that's what he should do with a free header. And Zoltan Gira will reflect on a chance that he had that probably wasn't as easy as that.
Louis Sahar scores his first ever Everton goal against the club where he spent 3 years and gave him his first break in English football.
Quick change for Roy Hodgson.
Substitution coming off number 11, Zoltan Gira, and his replacement number 23, Clint Dempsey.
Clint Dempsey, the USA international, takes his place.
Full marks to Leon Osman there. He was involved in that move an awful lot.
And so almost finding himself with a goal scoring chance seconds after coming off the bench. Hangerland. Will Everton get nervous now and try and defend their lead? Or will they just get the ball in the opposition half? They're trying to do the latter.
Well, my advice would be the same as it was to Arsenal midweek. At this stage in the game, keep the ball. No need to look for another goal. Keep the ball, work the clock.
They can keep it in the opposition half even better, but they've lost possession. And Murphy hits it long, looking for Zamora. I would say leave it, leave it. Waste for a few more seconds. Well, we're in November and Everton have yet to win a match at Goodison. But now they've just got a couple of minutes plus stoppage time to change that. The header through.
So flags went up against some order. But what a ball this is. Don't get to Pienaar quite enough, I mean to Osman quick enough, and that's what I mean about the header. Hit the target, at least make the goalkeeper save it. Louis Saha does just that. Fine header, powered it past Schwarzer.
And the man that David Moyes left out of the starting lineup has come up with what could be the winning goal.
Coming off number 25, Simon Davis. His replacement, number 10, Eric Davis.
He's replaced here by Eric Nevelin, whose appearances for Fulham have all been as a substitute this season.
No, I talked about that period between 80 and 90 minutes about this league, and now there's an awful lot of goals scored in that time, and Everton yet again have come up with a late, late one.
86 minutes and 13 seconds.
87th
minute. 86 minutes and 13 seconds.
Konchesky hits it long. Zamora beaten to it by the excellent Jagielka. There's a Nichovic. Neville. And Lang's header. Finds Nevelin.
And the fourth official is indicated there'll be a minimum of 3 minutes of added time. 3 minutes.
You can hear the loudspeaker announcements as well as we can. We don't need to tell you that.
I mean, it's quite loud here, isn't it?
Just a little bit, isn't it? We're playing the final 3 minutes, if you didn't hear it. Chesky battling now with Anicevic. Sahar. They can get the throw, just what they wanted.
No hurry here. For it to be.
Had crossed the line before
Once we made that tackle. I don't think they got that right now. It's got to go back, surely. Well, he might have been offside. Maybe that's what he's given. But anyway, it's Fulham's ball. And Schwarzer knows that he will have to get as much distance on this as he can. Oh, that was best. Ball up strongly against Hangeland. Konchesky curls it forward. Away by Yobo.
I think you always felt today, you know, the first goal, with the state of both teams, with their away form and their home form, was just such a big goal. Had Zoltán Gyira produced that same kind of result from his header, and Fulham might have gone on and won the game. As it was, it looks at the moment, and it always feels a little dangerous after what I saw on Wednesday night at the Emirates, it looks that that late Zaha goal might just give.
But wait, here's Johnson, and once more, Arteta in the right place. Hansel knocks it back in, Murphy's header. Arteta clears. Should be plenty of time for Hangeland, and there was.
One more attack, I guess. And here it comes. One more header he wins for Everton Field.
Maitland up strongly. Dempsey's with him. Now Murphy. On to Johnson. He seems to drop where Jagielka is standing. And this time where Yobo is standing. And each of it. Just seconds to go here. And each of these done brilliantly. And there's the final whistle. Everton's Goodison Park embarrassment is at last over, thanks to Louis Saha's first goal for the club against his old club Fulham, who hit the woodwork twice in the second half, and certainly probably feel they deserved a share of the points, but it wasn't to be. Everton have finally won here at Goodison. Fulham's four away record, however, continues. Everton 1, Fulham 0.
Louis, is that a big weight off your minds, first win at home?
Yeah, definitely. It's been a long time coming. We've not picked up the points we'd like to have at home so far this season. And, you know, we've not played well either. We played well last week against Manchester United in the second half, and we were hoping to carry that on this morning. You know, the performance wasn't what we were after, but the 3 points was vital today.
You left it very late. Did it feel like one of those games when neither side were going to edge it?
Yeah, it looked like it was going to be that way. We've won that way last two games. Bolton midweek was the same. It was a scrappy game and we nicked one late on. So, you know, we'd be happy if we did that every game to the end of the season.
Louis, I'm sure you weren't happy to start on the bench. What does it mean, your first goal for your new club?
Yeah, it's huge. I think we all work hard for that win. So it was a great opportunity to do it. And I think it helped me a lot to score that goal.
It's the best thing for a striker as well, when you've been left out, to get on and score.
Yeah, it's true, but you know, it's competition, and you know, we haven't played well like Ozzy said, so it's been very difficult right now. But I think it's going to come. We're playing better, so hopefully it's going to come.
Leon, what with this and the two results in the week, do you feel like you've turned the corner now?
We certainly hope so. You know, you can never say you've completely, you know, you're beyond it. You know, any game you go into, is you have to work hard to get that win. But we hope so. We've definitely took a big step in the right direction. You know, we've won our first home game, and we're now unbeaten in three. So, you know, we'll take the positives and move on to the next game and hopefully keep our run going.
Well, you were the Barclays man of the match today. Louis, can I ask you to hand the bottle over, please?
Thank you.
Thanks, Lou. Appreciate it. Thanks very much.
Cheers, guys. Hey, it was far from a classic, but do you care, given you got your first win at home?
Well, we'll always care how we perform, and it wasn't a good performance, but at this present time, the result was really important to us. Two wins in a week, so I'm really pleased with that.
Do you look at it as a building block to get your season going?
Yeah, well, we do, because, you know, we've kept another clean sheet today, albeit, I've got to say, you know, we had a little bit of good fortune a couple of times, but nevertheless, we'd one or two chances. We're a bit wasteful in the first half at times. And, you know, in the end, we got there near enough the last minute again.
How much do you think that will help Louis Saha getting off the mark for Everton as well?
I definitely think it will help him. You know, I think the goals always give the centre-forwards confidence. And it was always going to be tight. You look at Fulham's away record, they don't concede many goals. And it proved to be that again today.
David, thanks for your time.
Thank you. Cheers.